A commercial mission heads to the moon with NASA science. Our Artemis II crew conducts some pre-flight training, and a major milestone for a planetary science mission. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On February 15th, Intuitive Machines' first robotic lunar lander mission to the moon's surface launched aboard a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket from our Kennedy Space Center. The mission is carrying NASA scientific research and technology demonstrations to help us better understand the challenging environment of the lunar South Pole region and improve landing precision and safety ahead of future Artemis astronaut missions to the moon. As part of pre-flight training for their Artemis II mission around the moon next year, the Artemis II astronauts recently practiced the recovery procedures that will be used to safely retrieve the crew after they splash down in the Pacific Ocean at the end of the mission. Artemis II is the first crewed flight on NASA's path to establishing a long-term presence at the moon for scientific discovery and exploration through the Artemis campaign. Our Europa Clipper mission has passed a major milestone. With less than 9 months to go in the countdown to its launch, the massive spacecraft, which is being assembled at our Jet Propulsion Laboratory, has been outfitted with its science instruments. Set to launch in October 2024, the spacecraft will head to Jupiter's ice-covered moon, Europa, where a salty ocean beneath the frozen surface may hold conditions suitable for life. The Airborne and Satellite Investigation of Asian Air Quality, or ASIA-AQ mission, is a collaboration between NASA and Korea's National Institute of Environmental Research. The mission will use aircraft, including NASA's DC-8 and G-3 aircraft, satellites, and ground-based instruments to study the air quality in Asia as part of a global effort to better understand the air we breathe. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more about what else we're up to, check out nasa.gov.